How you doing there? Dom Tiberi here, joined by Dave Holmes and our man Adam King, joining us from Texas, the site of Friday's Cotton Bowl, where 7th-ranked Ohio State will tank on 9th-ranked Missouri. By the way, the Tigers are favored by a point in this game. Adam, you're down there, the Buckeyes working out inside AT&T Stadium, which is behind you. The big question, who's going to play in this game for the Buckeyes? That's the reason Ohio State is an underdog. Of course, a new quarterback, Devin Brown. Is he going to be playing catch with Marvin Harrison Jr.? Emeka, we assume, is playing. Who else is playing?
Well, I don't think Marvin Harrison Jr. is going to play on Friday. Today, he spent pretty much the entirety of the first 15 minutes of the practice on the exercise bike, didn't dress, was wearing his jersey, but was wearing kind of sweatpants. And I think this is something we've all seen coming, and it's understandable. I mean, when you're a projected top two pick, there's not a national title on the line. There's not a playoff spot on the line here at AT&T Stadium. And I do think this was something that Marvin thought for a while about. And there's a reason he's down here in Dallas with the team. He wants to be with his brothers here. He wants to be a part of this experience. But I'm sure there's a lot of people in his ear that said, hey, there's just too much on the line come April for you to lay it out there against Mizzou. The good news for the Buckeyes, they have a lot of really good wide receivers, young and up and coming. Carnell Tate and Brandon Innes are going to get a chance to show just how good they can be. Other than Marvin, though, my biggest takeaway from today is that I think we'll see every other Buckeye that can play health-wise take the field on Friday night.
So does that conclude JT Tuimoloau? Does that include Trey Henderson? Are they playing as far as you're concerned right now?
Well, I asked Jim Knoll straight up. I said, do you expect to have any opt-outs on defense? And he said, not that I know of. And, you know, that was the continued theme. We got to talk to the defense today. JT Tuimoloau was out there the entirety of practice running with the ones. I thought it was a little bit surprising that it was just business as usual, really, for this Buckeye defense. And when you look at the offensive side of the ball, Trey was out there getting reps with Devin Brown, the new QB1 and RB1 for Friday night. So, yeah, I do believe that everybody is going to play other than Marvin Harrison Jr.
You know, Dave, with that said, and you got to believe that these guys wouldn't be taking reps from guys that are going to play in the game unless they're playing. I mean, I can't imagine Trey Henderson saying, hey, I just want to practice, but I'm not going to play.
Yeah, exactly. If you're going to take reps from the other guys, I mean, because the most important part of the bowl season when you're not in the playoff hunt is you get an extra month of practice. And that's a chance for guys like Carnell Tate to get the reps. Adam mentioned Brandon Innes as well. Yeah, Trey Henderson, I mean, why would you practice if you don't plan on playing, especially from a health-wise standpoint, Don, because a non-contact ACL, you can pop an ACL in practice just as easily as in a game. So from a risk-reward standpoint, I would think if you're on the practice field at this point, taking part in full practice, you would be playing in the game on Friday.
And you look at a guy like Trey Henderson who said he was, you know, wasn't sure what he was going to do. I mean, you got my question is, does that mean he might come back next year now? I mean, are these guys going to play next year if they're going to play? I mean, why risk it if you can go to the NFL?
I always assumed Trey Henderson would be gone just because running backs have the shortest lifespan of any position in pro sports. But as we've seen, the Buckeyes not exactly fill out the running back depth chart. They've lost guys via the transfer portal. It seems like there's a little bit of momentum to suggest Trey Henderson would come back. That still would surprise me at this point, Dom, just because I think when you're a running back, you want to get that free agency clock ticking as soon as you can in your early 20s. But all signs are starting to point to maybe Henderson's not as gone as I thought he was.
Adam, as you look at this game, and obviously you've been down there, you watched them practice, talk is cheap. They're saying the right things, but let's face facts. This is not where they wanted to be. They did not want to play Missouri. I have said all along, I feel like this game is maybe bigger for Missouri. Do you get the feeling that they're going to be ready to play this game, a game they didn't want to be playing in?
I think they are driving home that SEC opponent. I think that matters. There's a little bit of pride on the line when it comes to that. And I do think the fact that everybody is going to play tells you what you need to know about their mentality with this game. I've heard a lot of people say that the coaches have done a really good job rallying this team back together. Today, Steel Chambers said Ryan Day kind of pulled everybody together and said, yes, We understand what happened in Michigan is not what we want. We're devastated, but it's time to get back to work. And I do believe, Don, that when they take the field on Friday, it's just competitors going against each other, and nobody wants to lose. I do think Missouri knows that this is a chance to get an absolute staple of a win for their program to try to keep rising up that tier. And for Ohio State, I mean, if you win the game, people say, that's great, you were supposed to win the game. And if you lose the game, people say, what's going on at Ohio State? I think it's a tough scenario to be in. So I think right now what the Buckeyes are treating it as is just another game. And I buy the talk. I think they're going to come out here and just play football and try to win.
You mentioned Ryan Day, clearly a devastating loss. And in my opinion, there's pressure on him to win this game. You don't want to lose two games in a row if you're coaching in Columbus, Ohio. With that said, what do you expect we see out of him from a coaching standpoint in this game? He's going to have a rookie quarterback out there who's making his first start. With that said, we saw what he did, the way he unleashed the dogs in that Georgia game a year ago after they had a heartbreaking loss to Michigan. What do you see? Think we see out of Ryan Day from a coaching standpoint?
Well, we've only seen one time in Ryan Day's tenure him coach with nothing on the line. I mean, I understand they want to win the, you know, want to win the game here, but really they're not playing for a national title. They're not playing Michigan. They've got nothing to lose. We saw that Rose Bowl game where C.J. Stroud threw for six touchdown passes, and obviously the defense didn't work out in that game. But I think Ryan Day is going to let it just flow here. He's going to let Devin Brown play the game he wants to play. I mean, you cannot lose in this game if you just go out and play. You're going to learn a lot about your young quarterback as he gets set for next year. And I think Ryan Day likes the opportunity to just kind of call a game that he wants to call loose and just kind of air it out football and use a running quarterback the way he wants. I think it'll be really interesting. I will say he seemed very loose today. You know, he was kind of walking around talking with the guys, smiling. It does look like this Buckeye team is starting to slowly move past what happened in Ann Arbor. And I think by Friday, they'll be ready to put it all behind them.
You know, Dave, with that said, and, you know, you grew up in this state. We know what it's like. Adam knows. He's from Gahanna. There is pressure, though, on Ryan Day to win this game. And he looks can be deceiving. He's got to win this game.
One of my favorite quotes from Ryan Day is when a game like this comes along where he says, you know, people say, oh, this game doesn't matter, then try losing it. That's what he always says. If it doesn't matter, try losing it and see how the town reacts. I mean, Ryan Day does not want any more negative momentum right now because he's hurt it all after losing three straight games to Michigan. He doesn't want to drop this one. Yeah, it doesn't matter, air quotes. Until you lose it, and then the fans say, oh, now we can't even beat Missouri, even if Marvin's out, even if Kyle McCord's at Syracuse, even if Chip Traynham's in Kentucky, all these different things. It doesn't matter. When you lose a game like this, you're going to hear it, and Ryan Day does not want to hear it. And it also comes down to, can you move on? Because I do think there's a leadership element here of how do you get your guys rallied again to play again. And we talked about Trey Henderson, Jack Sawyer, JT Tuimoloau, some of these guys we thought who might sit this game out and now are trending toward playing. And, Dom, I think a lot of that has to do with if it is their last game. Maybe it is. Maybe Trey Henderson does go pro. Maybe they just don't want to go out with a third straight loss to Michigan. Maybe they just want to at least write one more feel-good chapter. Even if they do go to the NFL, you'd much rather go out with a win than a loss to your rival.
Well, I would think everybody on this team has a chip, especially the defense, because, you know, they're not happy with how that second half went against Michigan, so they feel like they got something to prove. The game, though, in my opinion, will be on the quarterback's shoulders. Devin Brown making his first start. Obviously, he came here to play. I like some of the things he said. He comes across a little bit cocky.
He's got
a
swagger. He's got
a swagger. He's got a little bit of a swag. He feels like he's ready to show what he can do in this game. He's healthy. I think it was crazy people thinking Lincoln should get. I mean, the guy's got a handful. This guy was right in the and he actually played in games this year where it mattered. With that said, what do you expect we see out of him at quarterback? And is this his a job audition, I guess, for next year?
100%. This is his chance to go into next spring as the incumbent. If he goes out there and throws for 300 yards and three scores and the Buckeyes win, he will walk into spring with his shoulders high with that same swagger. If he goes out and throws three picks and the Buckeyes get run off the field, well, then Lincoln's in play. Then Aaron Nolan is a teenager and somehow in play. I mean, you don't want to do that. This is Devin Brown's chance to say, hey, Ryan, you got it wrong. I should have been the guy. I'm going to prove I'm the guy. and then he goes into spring as the man or expected to be the man. So to me, this is a huge game. And luckily for Devin Brown, if you're going to start a game, this is the time to do it when you had a full month to prepare and not make a switch midseason on just 4 or 5 days of practice. This is the right time to get acclimated as being the guy.
All right, guys, last couple things. Adam, I've said all along, and I'm going to say it again, don't sleep on Missouri. I think they want this game. They want to be in this game. This is a huge marquee game for them. It's a huge marquee game for the program. This will be the 13th meeting all time. Ohio State has dominated. 10 wins, one loss, one tie. Why should people not sleep on Missouri? I've watched them. They're a very good football team.
I mean, Missouri was in every game they played this year. They pushed Georgia to the brink for 3.5 quarters. They've got a Heisman-caliber running back. I mean, I think he finished 8th in the Heisman this year. They've got a million different things going for him. Eli Drinkwitz has taken this program from a place where it was kind of an afterthought. Sometimes they would, you know, maybe try and pull an upset, to now a team that is really up there with the second tier of the SEC. But that's the thing. They don't want to be the second tier. They're trying to come in here on Friday night and use this as a win to be a top-tier SEC team, to start spiking the football when it comes to a national level. And I think they're more than capable of doing that. I don't think that anybody should be sleeping on this Missouri team. They're here for a reason. But I do think that this Buckeye team, especially now that we know more so who's going to be on the field, is just a better team. And, you know, I understand Missouri's had a great season, but I do think this Buckeye team, Missouri's without their two star defenders. That's going to be tough with the linebacker and cornerback. And I think Ohio State, Devin Brown, is going to get a little bit of a chance to kind of pick apart that defense.
All right, Dave, last thing before we give our predictions. Ryan Day has to win this game. Mm-hmm. But he's also probably thinking about next year. Yep. How much is he thinking about that? And how much does he maybe want to go out there, make a statement with Devin Brown, with these guys, and use this as a launching pad for next season?
It's a delicate tap dance for Ryan Day in this game, because this is your first spring game before the real spring game. This is your first audition for what the next year Buckeyes could look like. But you don't want to lose back-to-back games. And I think in his head, he's probably tiptoeing that line the entire month of December. How do I get the experience I need, but still make sure I win the game? And I'm going to be very curious if that means he tucks it in number 32's belly 25 times if Trey Henderson plays, and go with what you know, which is defense, and you can run the football. Maybe that's what he does, but you want to see what Devin Brown can do. So I think he has to try to open it up. To me, this is one of the more interesting games to see how Ryan Day coaches. Is he going to coach like a guy who is afraid to lose a game, or a guy who's confident in who he is and looking purely to the future of the program?
And, you know, before we get predictions, I think the one thing we know for sure, Adam and Dave, is that Ryan Day is not going to tip his hand. We are not going to find out who's going to play for sure until they take the field on Friday. With that said, Adam, who wins, your score, and why?
I think Ohio State wins this game. I do think it's going to be a higher scoring game. I think that just sometimes happens in these kind of playoff game, New Year's Six games. It just seems that the scores continue to rise in these kind of battles. I think you see Devin Brown make a lot of great throws. I think that the Buckeyes probably come out and put 45 up on the board on this Missouri defense. But I do think that the Missouri offense, they're very good. I think this game probably ends up 45-31.
All right, Dave, your turn.
Well, first off, I hear the sirens, and apparently Adam's warrants have caught up to him. He crossed state lines, and they have finally found the man. Stay safe down there.
Yeah, there's a lot of them. We got to go. We got to wrap.
Yeah, we got to wrap before our man gets cuffed and thrown in the back of a squad car. My goodness. So who do I think wins the game? I think the Buckeyes win the game. I'm going 31-24. We've talked about it. Don't sleep on Missouri. This game does mean more to Missouri than it does Ohio State. Those are facts. This is a bigger game for them than if the Buckeyes were to beat them. So I do think Missouri is good. Now that Marvin Harrison Jr. is out, I think Luther Burden, Missouri's wide receiver, is the best player on the football field. Take it for what it's worth. Might be bulletin board material. He will be a top 10 pick in 2 years. So Missouri has confidence. They have talent. But like Adam was referencing, even if the Buckeyes are missing a few guys, the second string on Ohio State is still full of four-star players. I take Ohio State 31-24.
All right, and I'm going with Ohio State. Big surprise, but I am. You know, I think Ohio State, A, has better players. I think Devin Brown is going to be able to show what he can do. I like his cockiness, and I want to see him go out there and be successful. And I'll tell you the other thing is he's not going to be afraid to run. We saw that, what they put in, and I think that's going to be a huge difference. I do think I don't think Marvin's going to play. I don't think there's any way. And I'm not sure on Trey or any of those guys. I mean, until I actually see him suiting up. But with that said, I think Ohio State still has better players with the backups than Missouri. With that said, I'm taking Ohio State to win 38-21. So there you have it. Adam King is going to be in Dallas all week with the Buckeyes. Dave Holmes and I will be back here holding down the fort. Keep it on 10TV and 10TV.com for all your Buckeye football needs. And Happy New Year is on the way. Merry Christmas, and we'll see you soon.